Before you perform the manual cell count, you need to wash your hemocytometer.
It needs to be thoroughly clean. And the first step of that is to get your reagents and solutions ready. So you'll need to put on some gloves for that. And the first solution is some dilute bleach to disinfect our hemocytometers when we're completed with our counts. To do that, just take your beaker, I've labeled it dilute bleach, and we're just going to cover the bottom of the beaker with bleach, just enough to cover the bottom. And then we're going to fill up about 3/4 of the way with tap water. And we'll be using this later after we've completed the counts. So then this is the hemocytometer detergent. That needs to be about half full. And this is a dilute detergent that we use for cleaning the hemocytometers. And then you'll need a beaker about 3/4 full of deionized water. Now you need to take your gloves off. Most gloves will leave a sticky film on your hemocytometer and layer on top of your liquid, so you want to take them off at this point. Take off the cover of the petri dish, and here's the hemocytometer. I check it very carefully to see if there's any film or residue or debris on it. And even if I don't see any, I still wash it because there's often material on there that you can't see that will throw off your platelet counts quite a bit. So the first step is to swish it in the detergent like this, and then you can scrub it with your finger like this. And I do that, oh, 3 or 4 times actually. The more time you spend cleaning your hemocytometer, the better. If it's not perfectly clean, it will really throw off your counts. Then, the last time you scrub it, don't touch the surface again, because your fingers have oil droplets on it and they'll look just like platelets. It'll throw off your counts. So then you rinse it off in the detergent, then you're going to rinse it off in tap water. I use warm tap water. It cuts the detergent a little better. And then rinse it in deionized water, just like this. Then you shake off the excess water. Make sure you hold it securely so it doesn't drop and break. Then with a lint-free Kimwipe, it needs to be the Kimwipes that do not have kaolin in them so that you don't scratch the hemocytometer. You want to just gently wipe it dry. Don't do this. Just gently wipe it dry. Just like this. Then we will wash the cover slip the same way. So you want to look at your hemocytometer cover slip and check for any debris or film on it. Generally, the places that will have the most debris on it will be these corners here and these edges. That's where material is most likely to dry on the cover slip. So even if I don't see any material on it, I will still go through the washing procedure. And you'll swish it in the hemocytometer detergent. You can scrub it between your thumb and forefinger like this. And I pay particular attention to those corners and edges that I showed you. And I do that 3 times or sometimes 4 times, depending on how dirty it looked to begin with. Even if I've cleaned it the night before, I still clean it again in the morning. It's just so critical to the success of your counts to have it really, really clean. And then you always want to hold it from these sides, just like this. And after you've scrubbed it the last time, you don't want to touch the surface again because you want to avoid oil droplets from your fingers. Now we're going to rinse it in warm tap water, Yeah, we'll rinse it thoroughly in tap water. Shake off the excess water and then rinse it in deionized water here. And you can shake off the excess here. Now we're going to take another Kimwipe, lint-free Kimwipe, and we're just going to gently dry it in kind of a circular motion like this. And as it gets wet, we'll move it over to a dry area. And when we've finished, we'll check it for cleanliness. When you hold it up to the light, it should be perfectly clear, like a window. And you might even hold it up against something black. And it should be like a flawless mirror-like surface on there. I'm just going to sit it on top of my hemocytometer here. Then we need to prepare a moisture chamber. You can use a cut piece of filter paper, or you can use one of these blood blocks like this that I've cut into a circle. And you want to just barely moisten it. You don't want it sopping wet, or you'll get condensation in your under your cover slip, and that's not good. So this looks just about right. You can also add water with a pipette, with a transfer pipette if you like. Then we're going to put these two capillary tubes in there just to lift up the hemocytometer. It makes it a little easier to lift it out. And then we'll cover it to keep dust out of it. Now we have completed the washing of the hemocytometer.